In today's Hindu paper, that is today's 19th of September, this topic I am finding of importance for the civil services examination in the view that not because this news as such it is a political news, but the inherent constitutional provision in behind this news is important for the civil services examination. And this inherent political situation, the inherent thing behind this political institution in the constitution, you are finding in the form of anti-defection law. Anti-defection law. So this point, anti-defection law, that is important. So you just go a rapid reading of this news, you are finding that the disqualification of 18 MLA in Tamil Nadu is highly questionable. It is questionable on the basis of the provision extended in the 10th schedule of the constitution. So here it is telling that the disqualification of 18 dissident AIDMK legislators by the Tamil Nadu Assembly Speaker, I just note down the words, important words, dissident legislators, dissident MLA, speakers, is a partisan decisions on part of the speaker, it is telling, and aimed at securing majority for the 7-month-old that chief ministers, whatever that E.K. Palani Swami government, after a rebellion reduced it to minority. This minority, here some mathematics will be coming, but behind this mathematics, I will explain the mathematics, but I am giving you some of the important words that I have told you that this is related to anti-defection law. Anti-defection law, that is speaker decision under the 10th schedule of the constitution, is a subject to judicial review. Regarding the judicial review, 2 days back I have dealt with about this one, that High Court has given a decision that yes, no, and the floor, there will be no such type of the floor test up to 28th of September, whether High Court is able to give that type of the decision. That one, judicial activism and parliamentary proceedings, you all have written that write up, and I was very much impressed that in behind the write up, now we have to analyze the anti-defection law. So it is anti-defection law in the 10th schedule of the constitution, but please, my dear student, please note it and make a pause and note it that before this anti-defection law came in 10th schedule of the constitution, this 10th schedule was for the Sikkim. The Sikkim was a protectorate state and that was under the 10th schedule, but when it becomes merged with India, it becomes our integral part, then this was repealed and this 52nd amendment has come in picture. So I will deal with this one in detail, because one questions are always expected in PT from that aspect, 10th schedule. Okay. It is challenged, of course, to decide whether legislature withdrawing support to their own party government amounts to voluntarily giving up their membership, a condition under which a member may be disqualified. So voluntarily giving, then when a whip is disobeyed, whip is what is there, that whip is what. There is a case also has been discussed, that yes, similar type of the case in the Supreme Court, they have told that no, you cannot do. Now again in Tamil Nadu it is being done. The case is Balachandra L. Jarikhoi and others versus B.S. Yedurappa in 2011. The Supreme Court has made a decision that this type of the defection is not valid. So it is a decided case in the Karnataka, but still they have done. So we have to see some part of the mathematics also. What is the mathematics? What have been given on the first paragraph that required to be understood? So understanding the Tamil Nadu equation, the present condition, we will come to know about these aspects first, that what are the anti-defection law, what is whip, what are the history before for coming of the anti-defection, why it has come, what is 52nd amendment, what is 91st amendment, which articles of the constitutions are coming under it, this one, and what is the court judgment, and we have to make one analysis, and what type of multiple choice test questions can be asked from the anti-defection based on the Tamil Nadu incident. Let us try to understand the mathematics. Total seats in Tamil Nadu for the MLA is 234. Divide it by 2, then we are getting 117. Means for getting majority, we require 118. Okay, 118. AIDMK, that is the party, the majority party, that is not important from the examination point of view, that is, but I have to understand the mathematics. The AIDMK got how many seats? They have got 134 seats. 18 MLA are defectors. 18, almost 20 had told in certain news or certain to governor, informally maybe, they are formally also, informally, that we will defect. We will not vote in favor of the present government, Palaniswami. So, we will defect. So, if this suppose out of 134, 18 will be minus, 20 will be minus, then it will be 104. Means government will fall. Now, High Court has come in between. They told that no, just give time up to 20th September. Means people are in favor of saving the government, 20th September. And because these 20 are going to defect, so the High Court has given judicial activism, they cannot do. It should not be done because Supreme Court decisions are there. First point. Secondly, now the Speaker has done what? Speaker. Governor is also favoring that. Governor is telling that no floor test before at this time. So Governor is also favoring the government. Now Speaker, what he told, that he has disqualified the 18 members. Now let us change the color so that understand what the decision will mathematically it will be there. So High Court decision for the stay floor test. Meanwhile, Speaker disqualified these 18 members. Okay. Now 234 minus 18 means how many will be there? It will be 216. Now out of 216 only MLA will had remained, the total strength will be 206 divided by 2 is equal to 108. But they are having how many? 134 minus 20 means 114. Now they will clearly sway away. They will clearly have their chief ministership. So this majority need only 108, 109, and now they are having 114. So the articles under this anti-defection law says that still they did not disobey the whip. According to schedule 10, they are telling the speaker decision is very much invalid, but you just see chief minister will remain. So because speaker will have, definitely speaker will have a bang in the Supreme Court, he has to, judiciary will come in between, but at the same time you just see that schedule 10 calls the whip has not been applied. Whip means party has given the direction and the person has been served to do like that, and they abstained even after that in the proceedings in the house, then whip will be there, whip will be applicable. So there is a case that in the newspaper it has been given. This case is Balachandra, J. Jarkioli and others. Just let me see. Yes, this is there, Balachandra, J. L. Jarkioli and others versus B. S. Yedurappa, 2011. The Supreme Court has told that this type of defection is not allowed. This is really bad. So, this is the mathematics. Now, let us come to the anti-defection. This anti-defection law is contained in the 10th schedule of the Constitution. That you know, okay? You please have a notebook with you and write down the key words. Anti-defection law is in the 10th schedule of the Constitution because it is active listening. This type of the audio-video classes cannot be listened in a very, leisurely way as you are watching, because I know the mentality of most of the students, but I am just giving a word of caution that those students who have listened it leisurely and those students who have listened actively as if they are in a class and some good teacher is teaching and they are taking notes, they only could get some result in the examination. So chances of them are only bright. Okay. So anti-defection law is in the 10th schedule of the Constitution, which was introduced by the 52nd Amendment. 52nd Amendment, it was there in 1985. Indira Gandhi died in 1984, then Rajiv Gandhi came, and Rajiv Gandhi was having the clear majority due to the sympathy wave of the death of the assassination of the Indira Gandhi. He thought that it is a good measure, and my mother, she suffered heavily in 1967 election, and this was due to her downfall, and this was due to proclamation of emergency, having a black face in politics. He thought that with clear majority, I am in a much better position for this anti-defection law to come, and 52nd amendment came in parliament. And this 52nd amendment is a turning point because he has taken some clue from the international legislative procedures also. So it was valid to some extent. People had gone to the court. The court also told, no, it is not suppressing the freedom of expression. Anyhow, so earlier this 10th schedule, I was telling that the 10th schedule was there for the Sikkim, no? 10th schedule was related to association of Sikkim with India. Once Sikkim became full-fledged state, this schedule was repealed via the 36th Amendment Act, okay? 36th Amendment Act, it was repealed. And now in the 10th schedule, this one was there, that anti-defection has come. So this is important. Sikkim then 10th schedule, 36th amendment has taken place under the 10th schedule, and it has been repealed. Now in the 10th schedule, what has come? Has come anti-defection. Okay, anti-defection. That part is clear to you. Historical background, I was telling that what was the problem with Indira Gandhi, that originally the Constitution of India carried no difference to political parties and their existence. It was a multi-party system. It was evolved from the constitution in the early 1960s. There was no such type of the heat of the defection were felt. Nehru was having a very strong presence. Things became changed in 1967. 1967 is known as watershed movement in the India's democracy. It was very important landmark. It changed the political thinking. Then you see the party politics, the party funding, then the party should have money and all those things. In 1967, means the funding of the political parties is the, we at present we are finding that it is the bone of contention and bone of corruption. That is the year is the 1967. What happened in 1967? Some 16 states has gone for election, okay? They have gone for the polls, and Congress lost majority in them and was able to form government in only one state. Means opposition politics has dominated the scene. This was the beginning of the coalition era. Coalition, okay? Means, okay, we all will collide with each other, we all will make coalitions and we will form the government. This election also set off a large scale defection between 1967 to 1971, and there are evidences that 142 MP, just see, member of parliament, they defected, and 1900 MLAs defected between the 4 years, okay? So migrated in the political parties, and the government of many states beginning from Haryana collapsed. The defectors were awarded with plum ministries, like we just you choro party and we will give you plum posting. Okay, we will give you plum ministries. We will make you chief minister also, including chief ministership of Haryana. So in Haryana there was one legislator, his name was Gayalal, okay? He changed party 3 times, and he was always, any government was forming, he became the plum minister, okay? So all defectors was telling that, okay, Gayaram has come, Gayaram has gone. The name has becoming the, this one earlier, Ayaram Gayaram, okay? That phrase started, Ayaram Gayaram, because Gayalal has defected so many times. So, however, the issue was not addressed immediately. It took almost much year, I mean 67, then 1984-85, you just see, 52nd Amendment in the Constitution in 1985 inserted the 10th schedule and Constitution with provision of disqualification on the ground of defection. So, this part is clear. So, now we are clear about the anti-defection, first point, the history part, 52nd Amendment little bit, we will come to the Whip and Anti-Second Amendment subsequently. Now we just come to the, which were the articles which has to be considered under this 52nd Amendment. This was the Article 101, Parliamentary Proceeding, I mean chapter, please go to that, just have a background of the Parliamentary Proceedings, 101, 102, 190 and 191. These 4 articles got changed. Go to the parliamentary proceedings and you will find that in which way parliamentary proceedings going on. It laid down the process by which legislators may be disqualified on ground of defection. As per this process, a member of parliament or a state legislature can be disqualified on certain grounds. What were the grounds? Here in Tamil Nadu, you just see, they have not abstained. In anticipation of the becoming, they are abstaining or going against the this one party dictate, they had been expelled out. Here lies the questions of the UPSC that in they will ask on this point. First point of defection, members of a political party, that when voluntarily resigned from his party, voluntarily resigned, okay, I am the member and I have given the application that no, I resign from the party, or disobeyed the directive of the party leadership on a vote, means I have to prove that yes, I have disobeyed. You have told me that you should favor this the party leadership, but you have gone, disobeyed. Disobeyed has to be proved, not in anticipation, proved disobedience. That is the main call. Here the lies the questions for the civil services. And when he does not vote, abstains, as per the party whip, there they come the word whip, the party whip is there, and after that he disobey. However, the member has taken prior permission, or if he has taken the no, please, my wife is sick and within 15 days I have given the application, I will not be there, and the party considers, then it will not be there. But it will be clear disobedience, proved disobedience of the whip. So what the question can be asked in the civil services, I am just asking you. The question can be that consider the following statement about the whip regarding the speaker, or that he can expel a member from the party when there is a defection. He can expel a member from the house when there is a defection. Which of the statement he can expel a member from the house when there is a defection? You just see, they will try to differentiate between the party and the house. Okay, so which of the above statement is true? Then here only one statement, first statement is apart from the party he can be expelled if he is defecting it. Or the question can be asked in that way, consider the following statement regarding the implementation of anti-defection law. If an elected member voluntarily gives up his membership of political party, yes, correct. If an elected member votes or abstains from voting in such house contrary to any direction issued by his political party or anyone authorized to do so without obtaining a prior permission, yes, that is also true. So both will be correct. So this type of the questions can be asked. Okay. And in the constitution, there are certain provisions for the exceptions also. That if a person is elected as a speaker or chairman, then he could not resign from his party and rejoin the party if he demitted that post. No disqualification in the case. So here some important aspects, like if he becomes a speaker. Recently I have given you one class that the vice president, he wanted to retain the BJP membership also. Please make a write-up on that also, that whether vice president can retain the membership or not. Okay, a party could be merged into another at least by 1/3 of its party legislators. 1/3, it was under the 52nd amendment, voted for the merger. The law initially permitted splitting of the parties, but it has not been made 2/3. Okay, so 2/3 was not there, it was 1/3 in the 52nd amendment. That is also one important question the civil services. In regarding freedom of expression, there was a Supreme Court case, PIL, public interest litigation, was filed in the Supreme Court in the form of Kihoto Holam and Jinchulu and others in 1992. And this Supreme Court judgment is very much interesting, that the court has told that no, they have got the freedom of expression. Supreme Court upheld the constitutional validity of the 10th schedule court and decided that the law does not violate any right of free speech or basic structure of the parliamentary democracy. So this part is important, that has been discussed, and they found that it is not against the constitutional provisions of the freedom of expression. So this is about the 52nd amendment. Now let us come to the 91st amendment. It was there in 2003. Earlier 1/3 was required for the elected members of political party. was considered a merger. 91st constitutional amendment changed this, so now two-thirds now it is required. Two-thirds of the members of a party have to be in favor of the merger. So this is the change from the 52nd to 91st constitutional amendment. Okay, so this it has become now the two-thirds. Now let us understand the critical analysis of the anti-defection law. Critical analysis, what are the important points? That anti-defection law has enabled the political parties to have a stronger grip on their members. A stronger grip on their members, I am repeating the word, which many times have resulted into preventing them to vote for the lure of money or ministerial birth. It also provides stability to the government. So the stability analysis means here the stability is more important because election is a costly process. So stability is required. Stability of the government it ensures, and it also ensures the political party allegiance and the candidates elected with the help of the party support and on the basis of party manifestos only. The party has given certain manifesto, so he has to remain loyal to the party. So it is a test of the loyalty to some extent. However, it is also resulted into the unintended outcome, like sometimes the curtailing to a certain extent the role of MP or member of the state legislature, the antaratma ki awaaz, the voice of conscience sometimes are not being reflected, otherwise it will be whipped. So this is the major reasons that sometimes some dictator come, even after that the MP has to go with him. It is culminated into absence of constructive debates on critical policy issues because the member of the same party cannot do the critical discussion as it was being done, a healthy practice. The whip has become all the more powerful and has to be followed in all circumstances. So these are very important. Certain reforms, if these are there, the key reforms needed, your own viewpoint, if they ask, then only give, otherwise don't give, because it is a matter of constitution. The decision making power of the speaker chairman needs review. That thing, the decision making, here like in Tamil Nadu, this is the case. Here the decision making power of the speaker or chairman in the parliament, that will be very important, no? That he has just thrown them out. And the phrase voluntarily giving up membership is too vague and needs a comprehensive revision also. The political party should limit issuance of whip to instances only when government is in danger. Otherwise, they should allow the critical evaluations of the government policies. I may be a member of the political party, but I may have certain views and I should express it on behalf of the public of our constituency. So the election commission has recommended that decision under the 10th schedule should be made by the president governor on the binding advice of the election commission. A constitutional amendment vesting the power to decide matters related to disqualification on the ground of defection with the president governor acting on the advice of the election commission would actually help in preserving the integrity of the speaker's office. It is very interesting that what happens in this case, the governor's role has also come under the question mark. So this point has to be seen, that there should be an election commission decision. Election commission should give some advice to the governors that should be binding on him to some extent. That should be there, then neutrality can be maintained. This type of the reforms you can give the suggestions. So my dear student, anti-defection is all the way more important. Parliamentary proceedings in the 10th schedule, it has to be discussed. And with this one, I think that our overall objective is over, that with the Tamil Nadu case, we have understood the anti-defection law. Now you will ask that where is the write-up? Write-up is there on our site, Magnus IAS.com. And this I have deliberately put at present in the views on news series, and subsequently the same will go to the 10th schedule of the parliament, 10th schedule of the constitution. Okay, so there in the, it will be found at two places, views on news and in the polity, this constitution and governance. Okay, in this one, in chapter, perhaps in chapter 5 it will be discussed. Okay, so you will get all the write-up on this material, anti-defection question paper, every analysis there only. So save time and go on magnusis.com. thank you.